Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate Tip video. In this video, I will be talking about how you can lazily load one-to-one associations in a reliable way. But before we start, if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible fast persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Today's question is, I modeled a one-to-one association and activated lazy loading for it, but it doesn't work. How do I tell Hibernate to fetch a one-to-one association lazily? Configuring lazy loading for one-to-one associations is not as easy as it is for other associations. For all other association types, you just need to set the fetch type to fetch type lazy. Hibernate will then wait for you to use the relationship before it loads the associated entities. Unfortunately, that's not the case for one-to-one associations. It also depends on the mapping of the relationship and the Hibernate version you're using. A lot of developers model a one-to-one association using independent primary key columns for both tables and an additional foreign key column in one of the tables. That not only requires an additional database column, it also negatively affects your entity mapping. I will show you a more efficient way to model the association at the end of this video. The entity that represents the table containing the foreign key column is called the owning side of the association. On this entity, Hibernate supports lazy loading as expected. You just have to set the fetch attribute of the one-to-one association to fetch type lazy. But if you model this as a bidirectional association, you will quickly recognize that Hibernate always fetches the other end of the association eagerly. That's because Hibernate needs to know if it shall initialize the manuscript attribute with null or a proxy class. It can only find that out by querying the manuscript table to find a record that references this book entity. The Hibernate team decided that if they have to query the manuscript table anyways, it's best to fetch the associated entity eagerly. With some Hibernate versions, you can set the optional attribute of the one-to-one annotation to false to avoid the eager fetching. Hibernate then always initializes the manuscript attribute with a proxy object. Unfortunately, this doesn't work for all Hibernate versions. If it works with your Hibernate version, you need to be prepared that it might change with future updates. You can avoid all these problems and get rid of the foreign key column by using the same primary key value for both associated entities. You can do that by annotating the owning side of the association with maps ID. The shared primary key allows you to model the relationship as a unidirectional one. You no longer need the referencing side of the association. If you have a book entity object, you also know the primary key value of the associated manuscript entity. So you can simply use the find method on your entity manager to fetch the manuscript. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!